If you are a member, nobody said anything. Nobody said anything. And you know, when you hit somebody in front of his friend, you have insulted them all. Nobody could say anything to a man like Hamza. And he said, أَتَشْتُمُهُ وَأَنَا عَلَى دِينِهِ. Are you doing this to him and I am on his deen? He was not a Muslim at that time when he said that. But Allah wanted him to say that. Allah wanted him to say that word. He was not a Muslim. Hamza radiallahu anhu, at that time he was not a Muslim. But he became so attached to his nephew and his brother in Rada that he's not going to accept an injustice. Because I know what my nephew is saying. He's saying there is only one God. Well, tell him, no, we don't agree, but don't hurt him. You guys are cowards. You are harming a man just because he's saying, my Lord is one. Because speaking something, an opinion. It is said, طلبنا العلم للدنيا فأبى الله إلا أن يكون للدين. This is actually a saying of Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah. We have seek knowledge for the dunya, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no, 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 it's going to be for the deen. There are people who, when they start something, brothers, their niyyah is not really for the sake of Allah. But Allah turns their niyyah for him, their intention. For example, there are people who may come just to start. Then they end up good Muslims. Takbir. No. I mean, man, I didn't know that the dars was so good. Honestly, I give you an example. There are people who went to Iraq to liberate it from, Kuwait, to liberate it. They came here Muslims in 91. 5,000 of them. You might not know this. CNN doesn't talk about this. 5,000 American soldiers embraced Islam. In 91. Yeah. Now I don't know. More maybe. Takbir. It will do to them the same thing it did to the Mongols. The Mongols, when they came to attack Muslims, the Hulaku and the Genghis Khan, and then they went back, they took Islam back to Asia, and they spread Islam. And India became Muslim because of them, the Mongols. Not because Muslims are good, because Islam is good. Muslims are livestock. So, Hamza radiallahu anhu, when he started this, he was not sincere. But subhanAllah, he found out that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him, no, you are mine. Or you did one step, I will pull you now 10 steps towards me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pulled him to Islam, and he became Muslim. In the beginning, he was not. The proof is that he was still drinking until the ayah of وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْتُمْ سُكَارَى حَتَّى تَعْلَمُوا مَا تَقُولُ. Do not come to salat while you are intoxicated until you know what you are saying. So this is Sayyidina Hamza radiallahu anhu when he became Muslim. Since then, people started really not messing up that much with the Muslims. And may Allah guide some people, wallahi al-azim, who have influence. May Allah guide America to Islam. Imagine, brothers, that all America become Muslim and use the resources of the United States. So we are not against the United States, like some idiots may think. We ask Allah to guide America to become Muslim. Why not? And spread that, mashallah, all over the world. Umar ibn al-Khattab, the second big shot that embraced Islam is Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him. He used to be number one fatan. SubhanAllah, you have to know this. He was a problem maker for the Muslims. He was torturing his own slave, woman. And when he used to stop from punishing her, he used to say, don't think I am giving you a break. He's telling his slave woman, don't think I'm giving you a break or I am having some mercy. I'm just tired. I'm getting some breath to come back to you. This is how bad Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu was. But Umar is the type of people that only the shell from outside looks rigid and evil. Deep inside, he was extremely, extremely nice. Radiallahu anhu wa arda. So all he needed is that somebody breaks that chair. And there are many people like that. There are some very, very good people out there. If you just know how to bring them a little bit slowly to a dars like this, or to a masjid, or to a good person who knows how to touch their hearts. Break that chair. Deep inside there is a treasure of goodness. So, Zawjat Amir ibn Rabi'ah, the wife of this man called Amir ibn Abi Rabi'ah, she narrates a beautiful story about Umar. She said, we were preparing to go to Al-Habasha, and Amir, my husband, went to buy some stuff from the market. And as I was preparing our goods to leave Mecca, Umar ibn Khattab was mushrik at that time. He passed by and he saw me. And he said, أَتَنْطَلِقُونَ يَا أُمَّ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ? Are you leaving, O mother of Abdullah? She said, نعم, wallahi, we are leaving a land where you people don't leave us alone. You are harming us. You are talking bad about us. You are looking at us, giving us dirty looks. You are calling us names and you are torturing us. Leave us alone. And then she said that Umar told her, Sahibakumullah. May Allah be with you. May Allah be your companion. The woman, when her husband came back, she told him, I have seen some riqqa, some softness in the speech of Umar ibn Khattab. Ah, her husband said, come on, that man? You crazy. No, you were just dreaming. That's not the man who speaks softly. But the woman was right. So the intellect of the man was wrong, the atifa of the woman was right. The emotion of a woman was right, the intellect of a man was wrong. So don't think all the time you are right, brothers. Huh? Be careful. He told her, أَطَمِعْتِ فِي إِسْلَامِ? Are you hoping that he becomes Muslim? She said, yes. Wallahi, why not? He said, لَا يُسْلِمُ حَتَّى يُسْلِمَ حِمَارُ الْخَطَّابِ. Umar will never become Muslim until the donkey of his father becomes Muslim. By the way, something about the donkey of the father of Al-Khattab is the father of Umar. All the donkeys of Mecca go this way, and the donkey of Al-Khattab goes this way. I mean, super stubborn. So everybody was, if they want to make a fun or a joke about something, say he's stubborn like the donkey of Al-Khattab. So the man, Amir ibn Rabi'ah, was with the opinion that, no, I don't think Umar ibn Khattab will become ever Muslim. She said, I'm telling you, I have felt something in his heart. He might be rigid, and there are some men who yell, but deep inside they're so good. They're so good, alhamdulillah. Now, Umar ibn Khattab had emotions. Let's study the psychology of Umar ibn Khattab. He had mixed feelings between the tradition of his forefathers. He was confused. How can I leave? You know, when you are a man and you love your culture, it's very hard for you to give up the culture of your forefathers. Not because you are a bad person, just because were they all these years wrong? Yeah, let's make adhan and then we can continue, inshallah.